Jai Gurudev, my name is Vishnu Vandana and I am studying 9th class. I would like to tell about starfish. In Greek, ekon means hedgehog and derma means skin. Thus, these are spiny skinned organisms. These are exclusively free living marine animals. They are trypoblastic and have a columnic cavity. They also have a peculiar water driven tube system that they use for moving around. They have hard calcium carbonate structures that they use as a skeleton. Examples are starfish and sea urchins. Thank you.
Jai Gurudev, my name is Timon. I am studying 9th class. I am telling about hydrilla. Hydrilla is a plant that looks very similar to three other invasive plants, Egeria, Densa and Elodor canadensis. There are, however, some very ways to tell the difference. First of all, Egeria has the largest leaves of any of them growing up 1.5 inches in diameter and 3 by 4 inches to 5 by 4 inches.
Jai Gurudev, my name is Bhagavi. I am studying 9th class. This is probably the large group of animals. These animals are bilatery, symmetrical and segmented disease and open circulatory system, and also so the blood doesn't flow in well-defined blood vessels. The colonic cavity is filled with blood. They have jointed legs. The word arthropod means jointed legs. Some familiar examples are butterflies, cockroaches, houseflies, spiders, scorpions, scarabs, etc.
Jai Gurudev, today I am going to tell about Utricularia. Utricularia is the largest genus of carnivorous plants. It is one of the three genera that make up the bladderwort family, along with the butterworts and the cork screw plants. Thank you.
Jai Gurudev everyone, my name is Samira. I am from 9th class. My topic is tapeworm. The body of animals in this group is far more complexly designed than in the two other groups we are considered so far. The body is bilaterally symmetrical, meaning that the left and the right half of the body have same design. There are three layers of cells from which different tissues can be made. That is why such animals are called trypoblastic. This allows outside and inside body lining as well as some organs to be made. The body is planted ventrally from top to bottom. That is where these animals are called platforms. They are either free living or parasites. Some examples of free living animals like parasitic animals like terrariums and tapeworms.
Jai Gurudev, this is Kaushik studying 9th class. Today I am going to tell about the specimen leech. This is related to anelias. Anelias are bilaterally symmetrical and trypoblastic. But in addition, they have a body cavity. This allows true organs to be protected and body secured. There is thus extensive organ differentiation. This differentiation occurs in a segmental fashion with the segments lined up one up after to another. The anterior to posterior end. These animals are found in variety of habits, freshwater leech, marine nereids, and as well as land earthworms.
Jai Gurudev, my name is Dhirajas. I am studying 8th class. I am saying about centipedes. Centipedes are elongated mastic creatures with one pair of legs per body segment. Most centipedes are generally venomous and can inflict painful bites, injecting their venom through pinchers like appendages known as force clippers. Centipedes always have an odd number of pairs of legs. Thank you.